So I find that most people who have been through trauma or abuse or neglect or fearful situations, and I'm talking about people who have been in war or even just stressful life situations as they were growing up, often experience PTSD. And what happens in that, and number one, there's a revolving door that you can't get out of. It's just when something triggers you, it just sends you round and round and round. So most often what people do is they latch on to some one kind of pleasure. For some it's porn, for some it's alcohol, for some it's drugs or whatever it may be, Facebook. And that becomes the only pleasure, because you have to have a pleasure. You have to have some sort of pleasure in life, or it's, you know, the enemy will take that ground and keep you, keep you from wanting to live. So I'm not going to go in all that, because that's not my point of this today or God's point. If you want to learn how to deal with PTSD, I strongly recommend you get Arthur Burke's series on that. It's really, really good. But this is one of the first things he does, is that you have to build new neurotransmitters or neuropathways back up into the left brain, which is the pleasure center. So my point is, that's all well and good. And he talks about good things to experience as pleasure, like iced tea after you've been working outside all day and you're waiting, or ice cold water, or iced tea or whatever, and you anticipate and savor and all that good stuff. And that's great. And that begins to build neuropathways into things you can anticipate pleasure-wise to get you out of the PTSD syndrome. However, pleasure and joy are two separate different things. Like I said, the pleasure center is on the left side. The joy center is on the right side. And what happens is people who've not developed maturity and haven't gone through the pain of letting God show them how to move from even bad pleasures, even not so good pleasures, into things that bring him joy and ultimately you joy, don't know, and the discipline and the pain that comes from it, the discipline that comes from it, can't get there. They can't make the jump into the right brain joy center. So that needs to be a question that you need to ask God. If you were stuck, especially in a behavior that is, you know, it's not good. It can even be overeating, eating bad food, whatever. Things that are bad for you but give you a certain amount of pleasure, and they're better than what you were doing, but they're still not great. Ask God to show you how you can move that over into the joy, because and the joy center of what brings him joy and how to deal with it.